evening, everyone. We should be more excited than that. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Build Academy Cohort Number 2 Graduation and Pitch Competition. My name is Kendra Pruitt, and I have the pleasure and honor of serving as Chief of Staff at the City of Little Rock under the Honorable Mayor Frank Scott Jr., who you'll hear from in a little bit. But I wanted to first of all greet each and every one of you and thank you for your support of Build Academy. Build Academy is our very own at the City of Little Rock business incubator. We believe that small businesses and entrepreneurs in the City of Little Rock have the potential, but they just need opportunity. So Build Academy is where potential meets opportunity, and we give entrepreneurs right here in the 12th Street corridor an opportunity to grow and scale. And that's just what we've done. We launched this as a vision out of COVID, actually, where we saw that businesses had what they needed as far as potential, as far as passion and vision, but they might not have had the resources when we tried to give grants to small businesses. So we said, you know what? With Mayor Frank Scott Jr. at the helm, we want to do something about it. We aren't going to sit on the sidelines and see our small businesses struggle. Let's give them that opportunity and give them those resources they need to be successful. And that's where Build Academy launched. And this is a 12-week incubator. So kudos to those who have gone through this 12-week incubator. They spent every Thursday right here at Willie Hinton Business and Innovation Center, devoting their time to their craft, devoting their time to their businesses. And so let's give it up for them tonight, because that's who we're celebrating. We're extremely proud of each and every one of them, and you'll hear more about their businesses later. But I want to give an opportunity to thank our staff at the City of Little Rock who participate and give their time and effort to these businesses as well. We have Derek Rainey, who is our Small Business Development Coordinator at the City of Little Rock. Derek lives and breathes small business, and our cohort can tell you that, but he's housed right here at the Willie Hinton Business and Innovation Center. And so he not only serves our BUILD graduates, but he serves all small businesses in our city to make sure that they're vendors with our city and eventually can hopefully get city contracts. And so he works within our finance department through our procurement division to do and support small businesses in our city. And also we have James Owen. James is our policy analyst within the Office of Executive Administration. So all things data, all things policy, he provides that strategic and technical support to these small businesses to let them know the market analysis and where they're best placed at their business. So we're grateful for James and his leadership as well. And we also have April Hearn, who is the teacher and instructor for Build Academy. April has all the titles you can imagine at Pulaski Tech, and we're grateful that she devotes her time outside of teaching and being the dean at Pulaski Tech for entrepreneurship, but she gives that time to our City of Little Rock businesses as well. And I'm just, again, so grateful and so proud to see so many of you here to support our cohort. They've worked hard. They've taken a lot of criticism. And they are ready to tell you about their businesses and look for opportunities to continue to grow their businesses in our city. So with that being said, I want to introduce my boss, my mayor, your mayor, the Honorable Frank Scott Jr., to share a few words. Mayor Scott.
Now, that's the first time Kendra's ever called me her boss. I actually do what she tells me to do. And that's just a good thought in leadership. You always identify leaders that are more talented and smarter than you and not be intimidated by it. And so we found a jewel in Kendra, and Kendra shared my appreciation to you and to our entire team. So what I want to do is I'll be very brief. I know we have we already had the pitch competition? Oh, because I'll make sure we get to the real business of the day. I know they are all eager and waiting on this opportunity. But as mayor of this great city, I'm always focused on growth. But when you think about growth, you have to be intentional in where you grow. and who you grow with, and how you grow, and where you grow. And so when we think about potential meeting opportunity, I also want to talk about equity. And that's the reason why we're here today. Our internal why at the City of Little Rock is to unite, grow, and transform. And we do this all with an equity-driven policy lens, where we want to figure out who's been left out, who's been locked out, who has not been invited to the table, to figure out how they can grow, because if they grow, our entire city grows. And our entire city grows because our entire city now has a new lens, a new reflection point to understand how we can all be better. And so I'm always focusing on how can our city be better. Our city's seen close to 8,000 new jobs over the past 3 years, whether it's Amazon, Trader Joe's, Costco's, in the next few weeks, Topgolf will be announced on where the location is going to be. And so when you think about these new jobs, those are all the big jobs, right? But the jobs that truly emphasize Little Rock are small businesses. That is the backbone of our city. And what are we doing not only to help small businesses, but more importantly, what are we doing to help minority and women-owned businesses? And ensuring that they have access to capital, but honestly, to be equipped to even have the access to capital, so when they receive the access to capital, that they do not allow the capital to deplete themselves. And that's what we're learning here today, these 12 weeks, understanding how not only are we conducting our business, how are we managing our business, but how do we grow the business and ensure that everyone has a long-lasting business to continue to grow, to move from one employee that may be the entrepreneur or him or herself to 20, to 50, to 100, to 200, to one day 1,000. But we have to have the resources available. We have to have the ability to educate one another on what to do, how to do it, and when to do it. And that's what's going on in these 12. We are equipping these businesses to be better businesses, to ensure that they are doing all that they can do, not only for themselves, but to help our city grow. And so that's why we continue to lean in to ensure that we have potential meeting opportunity. But it doesn't happen without the village that's who we're all here today. Many of these entrepreneurs have family members and friends that are sowing seeds, using what they have to ensure that we prop up these businesses to continue to grow. But at the end of the day, what are we doing to ensure that they have access to capital, they are equipped to have this access to capital, and that's what we're here doing today. I just want to take time to share appreciation to the businesses, take time, appreciation to the City of Little Rock staff as we continue to drive equity-driven policies. And Build Academy is one of those policies that we want to see continue to grow, not only for the second cohort, but we hope to see one day that it's 20 to 50 cohorts. So thank you so much, and have a great day.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Are we excited to be here today? I mean, it is an amazing thing for us to be here at the Willie Hinton Center. There was someone who asked me even today, what did this used to be? And it used to be a school. What did that school represent? Represented divisiveness. Represented a past that we sometimes don't want to acknowledge. But what we have here today, those who came to our first Build Academy, it looked very different. But we actually want to show you what we're doing, because this is still in progress. The City of Little Rock has invested a lot of time and effort and energy and funding to restoring this to become a place of life. We want to show you what it used to look like, because y'all are sitting in greatness right now, but there's greatness even coming forward. So we're going to show you a little bit of a video of where we've come from and then where we're going.
Thank you.
Let's give it up for the work that has been done. And I don't know if you saw, but we had our fearless leader, Kendra Fruitt, there standing with our contractor. We want to acknowledge them as East Harding, as well as WDND Architects. And it was very important that I tell you this story because we said that Build Academy could not start until we brought newness to the place where we were having. When you walk into this place, we hope that you feel welcome, that you feel inspired. That's why it's being rebranded as the Willie Hinton Business and Innovation Center. We even have Mrs. Hinton here today, and she's also spoken about the transition and change that she's seen happen. So thank you, Mrs. Hinton, for the inspiration as well as the collaboration. And this is one of the renderings that was produced, and next door is where this office is. This is the Small Business Development Innovation Center, where businesses can come during the day and actually operate in the city facility so that you can move forward. And I want to also make sure that I introduce myself. I am Derek Rainey, a Small Business Development Coordinator. But it's not about me, and I think that's why I started that way. It is literally about all of the businesses who Mayor Scott said are going to take this city forward. We want to actually kind of share with you our sponsors that made this Build Academy possible. We have a gold sponsor. We have Garvin Engineering. We do have a representative here as well. We have Mary Fair. Please stand. And if you are representing the organization, please be acknowledged. So then we also have our silver sponsor. We have Simmons Bank. Is there someone from Simmons Bank here? We have East Harding Construction. They do send their congratulations to the team. They got a chance to have a session with them. Southern Bank Corp also is a partner on the civil level. And then we have Arvest Bank. We have Mike Ramirez. We have Hope Credit Union with Kimberly Lee. And we had another bronze sponsorship with Encore Bank, who hosted the cohort at their headquarters for just some fellowship time. So in honor of our sponsors, one of our sponsors created this video we want to share with you, which gives you a little bit of insight into Build Academy. Applicants to the Build Academy were in three categories. There was those who had an idea for a business, those who were startups, so 1 to 3 years, and then those who were established 3 to 5 years. We did have a couple businesses who were a little bit further along and they have income or revenue thresholds that they had to meet, or if they were over that, we would make a referral within our pathways. So we were looking for businesses who fit in those three categories, but that didn't have too much revenue, because then we also could refer them to our partners. But one of the things that we were looking for this time around was, do they have an idea of what they want to do? Even if they're an idea business, those who had a stronger sense of, I want to do export and import for groceries from Mexico to Little Rock, that's very specific. We wanted to know, are these businesses, do they have it in their heart first? Because that would translate in the business practice.
I think that Build Academy will really drive us towards a great future of success. And I think that an important part of that is not just seeing our business be successful, but allowing us to help other businesses within the Academy and throughout Little Rock be as successful as we have been. I think that they're going to provide a lot of training and a lot of support, a lot of opportunities that people don't necessarily get when they start their entrepreneurial journeys on their own.
I'm just excited for the opportunity. You know, when I applied, I honestly wasn't sure if I was going to make it because I was like, you know, they're probably going to be like, oh, she's just a makeup artist. You know, sometimes I don't feel important. But, you know, the fact that I'm here lets me know that I am. It actually has given me a boost of confidence to make me kind of want to reinvent myself and rebuild my brand and just become a new person and just new professionally. So I'm excited.
Tonight we discussed a model about open for business. A member from the Garvey Engineering Firm talked about being engaged and natural. And one thing that I did learn was that this was the second class. So obviously they did something right with the first class and was able to keep it going. They did mention that there wasn't an actual budget for the first class, so money came from somewhere, sponsorships and everything. So that tells that the word is getting out and people are excited about what's going on with Build Academy.
I've always had the attitude that if you're gonna do business somewhere, you need to be active in the community. You need to have people that live there, work there, pay taxes there, raise their kids there, and are give back to the community. And so this is one way that we can do that, to give back, because I believe a rising tide floats all boats, and this is part of us helping the tide rise.
It's important for businesses of any size to be able to grow and prosper in Little Rock. And I think that any business and any individual should be able to come here and be successful. And programs like this make that happen for anyone and gives them the resources and the opportunity to do that for themselves.
So I hope that you all caught some things that were said in there because you are a part of this growth. As we grow forward, providing economic equity for our residents and business owners here in the city of Little Rock, it takes all of us. And then Randall was correct. We started Build Academy on a prayer and a few donors. But look at where we are now. And those who spoke on that video and what you saw, that was from the first class. Imagine how much they've grown 12 weeks ago. And now where they will be for the next foreseeable future. So we're really excited because now we get the chance to graduate you into the next level of Build Academy, which is going on to our pathway partners. And we do want to acknowledge them. We are not trying to do this as a city of Little Rock to be the one-stop shop of business incubation. We actually support the ecosystem of small business development through the Venture Center, which actually some of our Build Academy graduates from last year are pitching right now at the Pitch and Pine event for cash and prizes. So it's very important that we support each other and we support the ASBTDC, which is the Arkansas Small Business Development Technology Development Center, as well as the SBA's program, and even Remix Ideas and Rocket Lab. So we want to acknowledge that we also have started a new program as well. It is in its pilot stage for our Hispanic businesses called Emprende through the Office of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. So we are trying to reach as many residents as possible to provide economic equity. So at this time, Mayor Scott, if you'll join us on stage, we're gonna go on and graduate our participants from Build Academy. When I call your name, please come up. Miss Akissi Brooks with Ambitious Girl Avenue. Thank you, Akissi. We have Amari Briggs with Amari B Studios. We have Jamaisha Gavan of Classic Chic Couture. We have Randall Scott with Dreamland Investment Properties. We have Jackie Robinson Jacko with It's on the Rocks with Jack. It's on the rocks. We have Mr. Johnny Wallace with Johnny T's Fishing Wings.
We have Miss Kenitra Jones with Kenitra's Travel. We have Maria Elena de Avila with Little Hills LLC and Little Hills Notary. This next one could not be with us today, but Dr. Marie Boone with MB Coaching. Can we give it up for her? We have Miss Lamisha Mitchell with Melanated Knowledge. We have Valerie Rasul with Moving Beyond Limits. We have Quinyana Mumford with Mumford & Associates. We have Danielle White with Natural State Selfie Pad. We have Temeritus Baker with Rock City Literacy. We have Sarita Robertson with S&J Marketing and Design. Sarita Robertson Poirier. Poirier, all right. We have Selena Felton with Selena's Realty. And last but not least, she could not be here. She's actually on a consulting job right now. We have Dr. Erica McCarroll with the OMA Group. Let's give it up for our graduates. So now that that's out the way, we're so excited to have our graduates pitch to you, and hopefully you are investors in their business. Raise your hand if you're an investor in their business. We all invest in when you go and visit their website, when you go to their food truck, when you call them for photos, you call them for your next home. So we are all investors, and we're so excited to have our graduates come up. We're going to do a slight scene change right now just to get ready for it. So if you will give us just a moment, we'll begin our pitch competition. Shortly. So if you, I think I have a slide here that'll kind of talk about what we're going to do. Each of our participants will have 2 minutes to pitch. This is not a slide deck that you're looking for going through PowerPoints and listening to someone. But hopefully you hear their mission, their vision, and their passion behind their business. And our only rule is that they have fun. So I think I have one more. There we go, or two more. So we have, this is the criteria that they will go through, and I want you to have a business that creates impact in the community. Mm-hmm. And I do want to introduce our judges. Okay, all right. Our judges are Mike Ramirez with Arvest Bank, and we have Ms. Kimberly Lee with Hope Credit Union, and then Ms. Mary Fair with Garver Engineering, or Garver specifically. All right, so we'll get set up if you'll just give us a moment. Thank you.
Let's give it up for our first contestant, Miss Akissi Brooks. Ms. Akissi Brooks.
quality mentoring is very important in the lives of girls. 130% of girls who have a mentor are more than likely to hold a leadership position in the future. 98% are more likely to become a mentor. 78% are more likely to volunteer regularly. And 55% are more likely to enroll in college. Hello, my name is Akissi Brooks, and I'm the founder of Ambitious Girls, Inc. and the owner of Ambitious Girl Avenue. But before that, I did not envision a future of motivating, empowering, and offering scholarships for over thousands of girls in the state of Arkansas, ages 9 through 18, when I was struggling with teen domestic violence or low self-esteem. All girls deserve a space where they can just be girls, which is why I created the Ambitious Girl Avenue. At school, girls share their teachers with their classmates, and at home, sometimes they share their parents with siblings. So having a space where they can just be girls to grow full of themselves in terms of love, esteem, worth, and confidence, and best of all, be ambitious as the sister next to them. This is why I'm passionate about what I do. This is why at Ambitious Girl Avenue, we created a gateway where girls can grow through scholarships and global initiatives such as trips to Ghana, where they can learn and exchange knowledge globally. So whether you are a parent who wants your girl involved, a supporter who wants to volunteer with us, or a sponsor who wants to support our initiatives, we have a space for you at the Ambitious Girl Avenue. Thank you.
Next, we will have Dreamland Investments with Mr. Randall Scott.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Randall Scott, and growing up as a child, I was taught all my life to work hard, not only from my parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, older brothers and sisters. Well, I took all that and eventually joined the corporate world. Well, unfortunately, after a few years in that, I found myself facing not one, not two, but three layoffs. Unfortunately, I survived it, but it taught me one thing, that I had to have a plan B to ensure that my family would be well taken care of. With that being said, Dreamland Investment Properties was born. So for all your electrical, real estate property needs, contact the licensed professionals at Dreamland Investment Properties, www.dreamlandip.com, servicing Central Arkansas and all surrounding areas.
Thank you, Randall. Next, we will have It's on the Rocks with Jack.
Hello. Did I hear someone say it's 5 o'clock somewhere? Or we need to go to happy hour? Or I can use a good cocktail? And you know we got to be 21 and above. My name is Jackie Robinson Jacko. I'm the owner of It's on the Rocks with Jack. It's on the Rocks with Jack provides mobile bartending services and mixology services within Central Arkansas and surrounding area. It's on the Rocks with Jack started around March 2019. I decided to attend bartending school at the Arkansas Bartending School located in Little Rock, Arkansas. I always had a passion for making cocktails for my friends and family. So It's on the Rocks would like to serve you and provide for you to make your day easy. It's on the Rocks also has a package which includes cocktails, classic cocktails, signature blend cocktail as well. It's on the Rocks with Jack also provide bartending service at your need. It's on the Rocks with Jack also provides, where I say I pour and you sip. But also, It's on the Rocks address that you drink responsibly. We want to make sure that you make a home safely. Also, have future plans. Hopefully, one day you'll be saying, It's on the Rocks with Jack, bartending school.
For our next contestant, we're going to bring up Miss Jamaisha Gavan with Classic Chic Couture.
I want you guys to take a moment to think back to when you were in elementary school. Grade school, junior high, even high school. Do you remember all of the fashions, the styles, and the trends that you saw in school? Well, for me, that was something that I paid a lot of attention to. I was very much into fashion, but for fashion, I wanted to be creative with the outfits that I put on. So I was always wearing flowers, bright colors, stripes, and anything that just made me feel good about myself. I would say at that time, I became a fashionista. I developed a true passion for fashion. And from that passion, Classic Chic Couture was born. I am Jamaisha Gavan, CEO and founder of Classic Chic Couture. Did you know that women spend over $26 billion a year on apparel? Classic Chic Couture is a global online storefront that sells all women's apparel from tops to bottoms, dresses, jumpsuits, rompers, accessories, and more. At Classic Chic Couture, we encourage women to embrace their own individuality and style through fashion. We're building a tribe of women that embrace each other and support each other through the power of social media. I am Jamaisha Gavan, and no matter if your style is classic, chic, or couture, you'll find your style here. We're changing the world one C3 babe at a time. Thank you.
And hopefully you see the QR code there. Please take a picture and go on there. All right, our next participant is Miss Amari Briggs with Amari B Studios.
When I was a little girl, only thing I loved doing was looking at magazines. I did not like going outside playing or anything like that. And today I still can't ride a bike. And the reason for that is because I loved fashion, I loved beauty, I loved anything regarding that. But then I got older and I was told, "You're pretty, but you're fat." I was abused in a relationship. I was made to feel that I was worthless. I wasn't worth anything or worthy of love, this, that, and the other. So one day, I met a woman. She had vitiligo. Half of her face was really light, the other half was dark. And all I helped her do was even out her skin tone. And when I did that, her confidence went from 0 to 100. That let me know the power of makeup. My name is Amari Briggs. I'm the owner of Amari B Studios. I am a makeup artist for over 20 years. I'm an esthetician and a wax specialist. I have a studio downtown, and my goal is to eventually expand that into a larger space where we have a collaborative space for artists of all types, whether it's a fashion designer, fashion stylist, painter, you name it, photographer, so on and so forth. But my ultimate goal in the end is to have a mobile beauty bus. Wouldn't you like the convenience of someone coming up to your business and you can take a healthy work break and you can come out and you can get a little mini massage or an express facial and you can go back out and you can conquer the world and do the things you need to do and be productive? That, you know, people don't understand that facials are very powerful. And I think if COVID taught us anything, the power of touch is extremely important. So we need that in order to, you know, grow and be well. So that's one of the things that I love. Studies show that facials decrease anxiety and help you overall be more productive and well. So if you invest in my business, we're going to take this thing to the next level, and we're going to bring wellness as a normal.
Next, we will have Ms. Valerie Rasool with Moving Beyond Limits.
What if gas prices was just a little bit lower Just a little bit, y'all. What if food was cheaper? What if, in fact, they put more food in there to match the prices? We're talking about what if now. So here's my reality that I had to face one day. Food versus bills. Food versus bills. My son looked at me, and we had to eat. So here's the deal. A couple of years ago, I was faced with a layoff, unfortunately. I had to learn the difference between needs versus wants. I had to sit my son down and make him understand the mere importance of needs versus wants. We created a little game out of it, the layoff. We got a little sticky pads, and we used to put all over the house, needs versus wants. Every time he turned on the water, I'll say, Merry Christmas. Every time he touched the toilet, Merry Christmas. Every time he went to the refrigerator, Merry Christmas. So developing that system, what did that do for him psychologically? Made him understand that Christmas was every single day. I made him understand that money is what it is, what we made it to be. I didn't want my son to think that we were in fact poor by any means. Money is what you make it. Okay? With that being said, fast forward. Understanding money. It's a topic in which that we don't like to talk about at all. A topic in which that we don't talk to our children about. 45% of parents don't talk to their children about money. Guess what? I talked to my son about money. The conversation in which that we talk about without frowning up on, that afforded me to teach him things that maybe he did not know. My name is Valerie Rasul. I'm the founder and owner of Movement Beyond Limits. I teach financial literacy classes. Thank you.
Y'all heard that, right? She talk about money. If you need to talk about money with your kids, holla at her. Our next contestant will be Tamaritis Baker with Rock City Literacy.
Hello, everyone. Literacy is defined as the ability to write, but more specifically, the ability to understand, evaluate, use, and engage to be successful in society. In Arkansas right now, 500,000 adults function at a basic literacy level. And sad to say, but 60% of our children also are below grade level. Poor literacy rates can make students feel incompetent, have low self-esteem, feel isolated, and also have a negative and adverse impact on their adult life if these issues are not recognized and eradicated. Rock City Literacy League provides innovative solutions for children and young adults of our future. Our mission is creating change, one life and one child at a time. I'm Tamaritis. I am part creator and founder with my husband, Dr. James Hollywood. With over 13 years of combined leadership experience, it starts 0 to 5. We acknowledge and we have witnessed the gaps that keep our children from flourishing, thriving socially, and growing without the positive influence. Between us, we hold 6 degrees and many certifications directly related to the well-being and safety of children. We noticed the need, and now we are approving and providing the solution. Rock City Literacy League is a nonprofit youth development program offering mentor services, academic tutoring, and holistic health consciousness. We are asking you to commit and collaborate with Rock City Literacy League as we invest in our children's futures, our next generation of leaders, and our future generation of Arkansas. By partnering together, we can all become what? Generational change makers. Rock City Literacy League.
Our next contestant will be Mr. Johnny Wallace with Johnny T's Fish and Wings.
How many of y'all love to eat?
Yeah.
How many times have y'all heard, I got the best this, I got the best that? in the whole entire city. I've known people that says it, and I can relate to that kind of claim of somebody saying, making those kind of statements. To me, I believe that everyone should strive to be the best. Good evening. I'm Johnny Wallace, owner of Johnny T's Fish and Wing Food Truck. Well, we don't claim to be the best, we strive to be the best. I've been cooking for over 20 plus years for private and social gatherings, AKA block parties, you know, and my mission is to give the community more bang for their buck. I try to give them more food than they will get anywhere else for your money. In other words, my focus is to help the families that don't have five-star restaurant income be able to enjoy or experience five-star restaurant taste. My vision is to own 3 brick and mortars within the next 5 years. And in return, I can help give employment to other people that need second chances just like I. See, when I was 18, I went to prison for 5 years. It changed my life. So now, my second chance is building a legacy for my sons. It's building a legacy for my sons so they will know no matter how hard your past was, regardless of what your past was, you can still make it. And in return, I went back to school. I got my associate degree in CAD. I got my bachelor's in business management. I started working for an engineering firm, and I helped create and design the Emmanuel Baptist Church on Shackelford. I did the Victory Building on Capitol. And I'm not gonna say this is funny, but I even helped design the east wing of the prison where I was housed. So when I say, or I tell you that anyone can make it,
thank y'all for your support as well.
Yeah.
And the food is good. Our next contestant will be Miss Kenitra with Kenitra's Travel. Please welcome her.
I would like for everyone to close their eyes for just a second. Just imagine that you're on a beach right now somewhere with a cocktail in your hand. The sun is beaming on you, and you're listening to the waves of the ocean. The average American spends nearly 200 hours a year daydreaming about vacation. I'm here to help you turn that dream into a reality. My name is Kenitra Jones, and I'm the owner of Kenitra's Travel, which is a full-service travel agency that specializes in customizing packages to include flights, resorts, excursions, you name it, it can be tailored to fit your budgets and needs. My focus is to create unique experiences and provide personalized service for clients that are looking to travel to international destinations. Clients that value the convenience of using a travel advisor. I became a travel consultant in 2018 after several years of traveling around the world and planning those trips on my own. I've been everywhere from Bali to Costa Rica to Thailand to the Bahamas. So I have firsthand experience and knowledge that you can't get if you try to book your trip through Expedia or Cheap Caribbean. Now, as we all know, during the pandemic, travel was completely shut down. But travel is back open now. People are eager to travel, travel restrictions are easing, and the numbers don't lie. The numbers for people traveling this year have increased by 25% versus pre-pandemic travel numbers. So that means that my business is growing to a capacity to where I can no longer do this alone. So with your investment into Kenitra's Travel, that will help me to build a team to assist with the overwhelming demand of people that are looking to utilize my services. So don't go spend 10 to 20 hours of your time researching your own vacation that you know nothing about, that destination. Allow Kenitra's Travel to help you take the work out of planning a vacation. Thank you.
Let's give it up for Ms. Kenitra Jones. Y'all ready to book that trip? And our next contestant is Ms. Selena Felton with Selena's Realty.
Hi guys, so they asked me to learn how to pitch. I'm gonna give it my best. It's running. So let me just tell you a little bit about, but I wanna go back to why I do what I do. Every time I sit on that closing table and look at my client's face, signing the document, and their key for the forever home, it's a feeling that I cannot explain. It's just priceless to me. You see, buying a home is really challenging already. I have to mingle between accountants, inspections, contracts. Now, top it off with challenging barrier languages and don't even know where to begin. When I arrived to the United States almost 20 years ago, I found myself full of opportunities, but I also found a lot of challenges. One of those was buying a home. I thought I was ready, I was making the money, I was ready to buy, and I hit the wall when I was not qualified. My husband's grade was the worst. So it took me a lot of time, but I also learned a lot. I learned the American way to be able to reach the goal of owning. I learned the accounting side, all these plus and goals. My name is Selena Felton. I'm with Selena Realty. My mission is to provide resources and guidance to the Hispanic community so they can reach the goal of owning. I will hold their hand every single step of the way, make sure they are reaching that goal and make it to that goal.
Thank you, Selena, for the work that you do providing economic equity. Our next contestant is Ms. Lamicha Mitchell with Melanated Knowledge.
Good evening. Let's take a moment and inhale and exhale. Now imagine a four-year-old who throws a temper tantrum, who's throwing their toys, who has all of their emotions all over the place. Now, imagine a 30-year-old who has anxiety, who has depression, whose emotions are also all over the place. Now imagine them learning techniques such as breathing or mindfulness to be able to gain the consciousness of their mind, their body, and their soul to be able to calm down and be who they want to be in that moment. Something as simple as round and round the garden goes the teddy bear. One step, two step, tickle under there for a four-year-old. Or something as simple as a for that 30-year-old helps them to gain that mental consciousness and be able to calm down in their moment. My name is Lamisha Mitchell. I am with Melanated Knowledge. I am the founder and the owner of Melanated Knowledge. I am a yoga instructor who has been practicing yoga for 7 years, over 7 years. I've been able to teach in schools. I've been able to teach in parks. I've been able to teach all over the city of Little Rock. Melanated Knowledge is a holistic business that helps people to gain mindfulness through yoga, meditation, and different breathing techniques. I have been doing yoga for a minute now for so many kids and women and children, but being in Build Academy, it's taught me to be able to open up yoga for everyone. My focus first began for women and for those children. And now I hope to be able to tell all people how to learn to gain consciousness through meditation, through mindfulness, and through yoga in the city of Little Rock. I hope to open a yoga studio in the neighborhood as such, or in other neighborhoods throughout the city. Again, my name is Lamisha Mitchell. I'm a yoga instructor, and Melanated Knowledge is my company.
Don't you feel at peace right now? And next, coming to the stage, we welcome Danielle with Natural State Selfie Pad.
Hello, everyone. Are you tired of your guests at your weddings, birthday parties, company events, corporate functions looking like this? My name is Danielle White, and I own and manage Natural State Selfie Pad. We provide photo booth services for events of all kinds. Guests will grab a prop, interact with one of our machines, snap a photo, and instantly print their photo on the spot and text it to their mobile devices. All photos will include a customized photo border, all graphically designed by me, that can include names, hashtags, a picture of the client, or even your company logo. Hey, that's free advertising when they put it on their refrigerator or post it on social media. We pride ourselves in offering affordable photo booth packages, excellent customer service, and high quality photo booth services. All of our packages include unlimited photos, fun props, a gorgeous backdrop, and the client will receive a digital link of all copies of their photos taken from their event. We have experience in hosting small and large events like the Arkansas State Fair, social events like the Jingle Mingle, and we were even hired by Sam's Club on Bowman for their re-grand opening, where I don't know if he remembers, but the mayor himself stepped up to take a picture with us. In fact, we have one of our photo booth machines right out here today. I encourage everybody to stop by, take a picture, and take a very own Build Academy keepsake with them. So if you are ready to turn this into this, contact us today for your event.
Next, we'll bring to the stage Ms. Sarita Poirier with S&J Marketing and Design.
Raise your hand if you've ever seen a television commercial or an advertisement and thought to yourself, wow, was there anybody in the room that looked like me when they created this ad? Unfortunately, that happens pretty frequently in the marketing industry. And while companies have taken great strides to be more inclusive in their advertising, there is still a long way for us to go. That's where S&J Marketing and Design comes in. My name is Sarita Poirier, and I am one of the two co-founders of S&J Marketing and Design. We help companies and businesses develop solutions that help them reach and connect with all audiences, not just, you know, particular ones. So we offer a range of services from branding and identity to graphic design and website design. Our goal is to help businesses thrive. So we want to increase diversity and inclusion in the industry, and we are on a mission to help businesses not only make a huge impact, but also to make an impact that people see themselves in what it is that they're looking at. We want to continue on this mission until all people, specifically all women, have an opportunity, an equal opportunity for success. Will you join us?
Good job, Sarita. And next we will have Miss Maria with Little Hills Notary Service, an LLC.
From the little hills of Little Rock emerge the need to serve a new culturally and linguistically different population. According to the 2020 U.S. Census, there are 52,000 Spanish speakers in Lonoc, Saline, Falkirk, and Pulaski County alone. Imagine that you are in jail, in a detention center, in a hospital, or in a nursing home, and you do not understand the legal system nor the language, but you are bounded by all the legal obligations that everyone else. Now, imagine that all of your notarial needs can be served by the competent, innovative, certified, and bonded Little Hills mobile notary firm that I, Maria Elena de Avila, oversee. One of our experts will provide you with unsurpassed customer service in a personalized, reliable, cost-efficient manner for your peace of mind. Thank you.
Thank you, Maria, to service as needed. And our next contestant is Ms. Quinyata Mumford with Mumford and Associates.
$3,703. That is the number of suicide attempts among young people, 15 to 24, every day. 3,703. When I think about that number, I have to reflect. As a product of a single parent home, a product of a rural community, a product of poverty, a product of, some of you guys may not know, projects. I've been blessed. But what I didn't have to deal with that our youth have to deal with today is I don't have to deal with social media. You see, growing up, the biggest thing I had to worry about was whether or not I could quietly sneak the phone to my room using that long cord. But kids today are constantly comparing themselves to others because they're always connected. They're always seeing Kim Kardashian, Beyonce, the young lady that is having the lavish Sweet 16. Growing up, there was no Growing up, there was no Facebook. There was no Instagram. In fact, I didn't know that I was different because everybody around me was poor. Everybody around me has cinder block walls because we all lived in the projects. Sure, dealt with bullying. Sure, we dealt with acne and obesity, incarcerated parents. But when you combine that with social media and the good old COVID pandemic, where kids are constantly connected but being forced to be disconnected because of social isolation, what we get is a growing number from 3,703. What we get is a nation where 8.9 children out of 100 attempt to commit suicide annually. The goal of the nation is to reduce that from 8.9 to 1.8. A big difference. How do we get there? We have to have solutions. We have to have solutions that are out of the box. We've got to have solutions that come from people that grew up in the projects, that actually experienced poverty. As a public health practitioner, what I know is that the people in the room are often privileged. And so when they're designing interventions, those interventions are not reflective of the communities that are being impacted. It's not reflective of the 3,700 that we see. My name is Quinata Mumford. I'm your certified health education specialist. What that means is that I'm trained to recognize theories that help us move forward from 8.9 to 1.8. Mumford & Associates is a health education and promotion firm. What we do is we create health education that people can relate to. We have three E's. Education. We want to give you the knowledge, skills, and ability. But once you educate people, you've got to keep them engaged. So in order to impact the vulnerable communities, you've got to have people from those communities that are willing to stay in the community. So we want to engage them and get them involved in creating interventions. But in order to do that, you've got to have a third E, and that third E is empowerment. We've got to empower them to help themselves, but then we also got to empower them to help others. During the pandemic, we rolled out Youth Mental Health First Aid, where we target youth-serving organizations to equip them with the knowledge, skills, and abilities to be a bridge in our overly tasked mental health system. People say, hey, get them in therapy. If I want to take my life, getting in therapy in 6 weeks is not efficient. I've got to have an adult that I can go to that can benefit me right now. What do I say? What do I do? Well, let me tell you. Back in the day when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore, but some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. But kids today are not living the life that we lived then. It's compounded with so much more. And so we train people to recognize why saying when I was a kid is inefficient. What do you do? How do you serve as a resource? So that's Youth Mental Health First Aid. We're also rolling out Teen Mental Health First Aid, because if a teen is going to attempt to take their life, who are they going to lean to first? Their peers. We want to equip teens with the knowledge, skills, and abilities to be able to serve as a resource. I'm Quinata Mumford, your certified health education specialist.
Yes, ma'am. And part of the best class of Leadership Greater Little Rock, 37. Our next and last contestant actually could not be here, but she did send her pitch. She wanted to share with you what her business is. And this is Dr. Erica McCarroll with the OMA Group.
Who remembers what you were doing on March 10th, 2022? That was the day that our lives changed drastically in Little Rock, Arkansas. The pandemic caused us to shine a spotlight on suicide rates, child abuse, domestic violence, unnecessary excessive force with Black males from law enforcement, which resulted in tense race relations and led to the Great Resignation, as citizens began to focus on things that were most important to them. I am Erica O'Neill McCarroll with OMA Wellness. OMA stands for O'Neill McCarroll and Associates. We specialize in health and wellness coaching, stress reduction coaching, and mindfulness coaching. Post-COVID, we are all working on finding balance and increased quality of life. Give us a try at OMA Wellness as we all work on finding balance and increased quality of life. Give us a try as you work to discover your passions and to become the best version of yourself. Choose OMA Wellness for transformational growth.
I would like to ask us to give all of our participants a round of applause. If you haven't been up here, you don't know what it's like. So congratulations and good job to everyone. At this time, I'm glad I don't have the role of choosing and scoring, but our judges are gonna take a moment and they're gonna go with our fearless chief of staff to score these pitches. But while we wait, we have some things that we're gonna do, but you all are gonna go. So let's give our judges a hand, let's thank them. All right, so we want to just kind of recap some of the experiences that we've had over the last 12 weeks. So while they're scoring and they're talking, please enjoy the slideshow.
Thank you for your patience and participation. Hey, hey. So one of the things we wanted to make sure we acknowledge our judges, thank you for your support. And as sponsors, really investing in the development of Build Academy. We could not do this without y'all. It really does go a long way. I do want to give you a moment if you would like to say something regarding what you've seen so far.
Yeah, why don't we give everyone a round of applause? All the businesses and that participated, I know it's hard. You know, I've never had the pitch before, but one thing I can tell you is I'm a second generation business owner. And one thing that I have clear is that we build wealth through two avenues, you know, through home ownership and through small business. I can attest to that. You know, my family have built wealth through entrepreneurship. They're owners of a restaurant, owners of investment property. And that's something that, you know, we are building, or everyone here that has a business, to all the contestants here, that's something that's going to go a long way, that's going to create that generational wealth for your family. So again, you know, I'm happy, delighted. Something that Arvis is very proud to do is really invest in entrepreneurship and small businesses. So like Mayor Scott said, you know, they're the backbone of our communities, of our state. So thanks for inviting me.
Right. And we'll bring up Ms. Kimberly Lee with Hope Credit Union.
Good evening, everybody. Congratulations to everybody again. The one thing I want to say is don't stop after tonight, okay? And everyone that came to each of your class, contact them. The things that they said that they will do, remind them. And I'm one of them. So y'all have my business card. You got my email. Contact me. Hold me accountable, because that's what we're here for. We can talk about our employers all day, but if we say we want to invest in you, we want to give back to you, we want to help you, that's what we're here for. So contact everybody that came to your class and don't stop here. And the way you sold us tonight, you do that at the bank, okay?
Thank you, Kim. And bring in Mary Fair from Garver. Also part of the best class of leadership grade at Little Rock, 37.
37. I just want to say, reiterate what the other judges said. Congratulations. I was at the first session, and it was incredible to see how far all of y'all have come. I mean, y'all did an incredible job tonight. I know where I'm having dinner this weekend. I know who I'm calling for my next vacation to get some meditation. I mean, I was so impressed. Just the passion and the ideas that y'all have are just incredible. And I look forward to seeing how the impacts you have on our city and in all of our communities. So thank you for participating in Build, and congratulations.
Thank you, Mayor. So now, without further ado, Mayor Scott, if you could come on up here with me.
Okay.
All right. So one of the things we wanted to highlight is that each Build participant will get a toolkit once they have graduated, which they have. Those include the following. We have a co-working space. We have free marketing and promotional opportunities with Little Rock. LRTV, mentorship from the Little Rock Regional Chamber of Commerce, support from the City of Little Rock and our partners for technical assistance, waiving the city business license fee.
Yeah.
That can make or break a business right there. And then also just having free and business banking accounts without a fee. So our partners have agreed to waive those fees for a certain amount of time, but they are forming relationships with our businesses so they can grow. The last piece is introduction to and connections to other incubators, as I had mentioned. This is a pathway opportunity, and they are encouraged to go to the next level within their business development.
So without further ado, we're going to get to these prizes. All right. Woo! Can we give it up? Can we give it up? Because coming in third place, we have Little Hills Mobile Notary. Woo! I was told to wait on my drum roll.
It ain't working.
And second place, we have Ambitious Girl Avenue. And first place, we have Kanisha's Travel!
Going on a trip.
So we do want to recognize that those prizes came with some cash.
Yeah.
Third place walked away with $500 towards her business. Second place walked away with $750 towards their business. And first place walked away with $1,000 towards her business. But we're not finished yet. The alumni have gathered to support the businesses coming after them. So we have three honorees of the Alumni Bill Legacy Award, and we have Mr. Johnny T. Fisher Wings. Also, we have Classic Chic Couture. And we have Natural Stay Selfie Bag.
Awesome.
So the alumni have funded that award. It's still growing, so I can't tell you what it is. But thank you to our alumni who are in the room. Let's give it up for our alumni, please. All right. Good job. And we're still not finished, guys, because every single Bill participant will walk away with $300 towards your business to be able to help fund your next dream opportunity. So can we give it up for our Bill participants, y'all? Everybody who came out, who spoke. Once again, we want to thank our partners. We have Garver, we have Simmons Bank, East Harding, Southern Bancorp, Arvest, Hope Credit Union, and Encore Bank. And with that, we would like to thank you for your support. Please enjoy a selfie as well as food next door. We'll see you next time at Build Academy.